Filming from Django 2017, here's Marco Arnaudo, and in this video we're taking a look at The Witching Hour. This is a new game by WizKid. It has been released here at Gen Con, and the person who's going to help us get a sense of the game is none other than the designer, Ken Shannon. Thank you, Ken.
Good morning. So this is Approaching Dawn, The Witching Hour, and the concept of the game is that you are a coven of witches, and over the last year at least one or more of you has done something wrong, and now your personal demons are manifesting on Halloween to attack you individually. What makes the game interesting is, on top of all the simultaneous play that happens, everything you do to help yourself hurts the person to your left. So the risk and all the management is what you're doing to other people, not to yourself.
But the game is cooperative, and
it's
100%
cooperative. Any one person dies, gets too much corruption, everyone fails. Mm-hmm. So you have to work. You have to work together. But a lot of it is having to make individual decisions. So unlike most cooperative games, you actually have to figure it out for yourself. You can't let another person, an alpha gamer, kind of take over for you.
That is very important. We have seen that happening in too many games.
Yeah, so the other thing that makes it interesting is it's actually set up as a story game. So you can play it as a series over the course of a year. Think like a TV show. Where there's different scenarios that change how the game is played. So there's a lot of replayability. There's 8 different witches, but 3 to 6 players, like as I said before. So as you play through the game, each time can be a different experience and changes it up. Mm-hmm. It also increases or decreases the amount of time you play. So if you don't want to play a game that's too long, you can play one of the shorter scenarios. Or if you want to play one of the longer ones that are more crazy, you can go that way.
Excellent. Can you give us a sense of how this all works? I mean,
sure.
This is how the game looks like around setup, right?
Sure. So that center pentagram there is like a classic deck builder's where you buy the cards. So those are where you're going to buy your cards. You'll notice that there's little tokens on some of the card piles. That stops you from buying spells from there. If a person progresses their secret, remember how I said everybody's got something that they did wrong?
Uh-huh.
If they progress their secret, that token will move off, and then you can buy spells from the more powerful decks. So as you play the game, if you progress your secret, you'll give everyone access to more powerful things. Anything you buy goes to the top of your deck, so you don't have to wait. You get it that turn.
That's sweet.
Right and fast. And then it's played over the course of 6 hours, generally, on the clock. So that's the gist there. How the actual game is played is you draw 5 cards, or more, depending. And most cards can be played as either black or white magic.
Oh, so, I like that.
So you choose, everybody chooses simultaneously, and then everybody plays their hand at the same time. So no one can be like, hey, do this. Except for occasionally they'll get a card that says you can talk to the player to your left, etc. So when you have when you go ahead and use your magic, your black magic helps you destroy demons. So for example, this demon, I could just turn him off for a turn for one, or I could blow him up and kill him for 4. So I can use that 4 black magic to blow him up. The problem is I've just put 4 corruption onto the person to my left.
Oh, I see.
Anybody who gets to 20 or more corruption at certain points in the game will die, and we all lose. So white magic is very rare. You put it into a pool, which is over here where it says white magic pool, and then you can use that magic to help anyone else for yourself.
Wait, again? I didn't... Oh, there it is.
The white magic over here, it actually has...
I got it. I see it. Okay. That corner there.
So that can actually be used to help anyone else but yourself. Blow up their stuff and help them with their things. Later scenarios might do other neat things like heal them, let them buy extra cards, etc. So white magic is for everyone but doesn't help you. Black magic hurts the person to your left but helps you deal with the things in front of you. And everybody does that simultaneously, and then they'll have a secret. For example, this one says you may add 1 to this card in any hour that you did not cause the witch to your left to gain corruption. So if I had played this all as white magic, I might have played this all as white magic, and then everybody's like, well, why did you do that? You just hurt yourself. But then I progress my secret. If I resolve it, once this is 3 or less, or once it has 3 of these on the card, I get to resolve it, and then my token comes off. We can buy spells for my deck the rest of the game.
Are you allowed to tell them that there is a reason why you took that
silly
move?
Well, people kind of figure it out.
Or...
Oh. People kind of, yeah, you can't talk about the cards you have, but you can say, like, there's obviously something going on here.
If
you need to. But the...
Because otherwise my friends would always assume a mistake. Because I make mistakes all the time.
If you fail to do it by the end of the game, the witch to your left takes 9.
Oh, so that's heavy.
That's a horrible thing. So you could decide not to if you're going to keep them at low corruption the whole game, or you might go ahead and tag them. In addition, all the witches have their own special decks and special abilities. So that's kind of neat.
That sounds great. How long does it take typically to play?
Once you learn how to play, it's anywhere from 45 minutes to about an hour and a half.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on the scenario. So you can choose which one. Each of them tell you, I'll pick this one up. Not only does it have a little story to progress and tells you what's going on, each of the characters have a story in the book. It also tells you how much time it will take to play. So 15 minutes per player.
Oh, excellent.
All the special cards are, this sets up the game.
Very good.
So nice and easy.
Thank you so much.
Sure.
Thank you for taking the time to tell us about your game. The Witching Hour, available here at GenCon 2017, and then also available in the general market soon.
Yeah, late September, early October, around Halloween.
Sounds great. Thank you.
Sure.